Put God first, Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment.
I'm gonna just keep singing this song over your life, man. Is that cool? Bless you, bro. Let me just say, more favor coming your way. Oh, very soon. You believe in me?
Read the Bible.
At Don't You Scroll, come here. We read in the Bible. Luke, toward the end of chapter 8, there's a man in the Bible. His name is Jairus. He is making his way to Jesus because his daughter is dying. As he gets to Jesus, in the midst of Jesus healing somebody else, his daughter dies. There's a man that comes from the house to go ahead and tell him, hey, dog, she dead. Leave Jesus alone. He don't say it like that, but you know, he literally is like, she's dead. Leave the teacher alone. Don't ask him for nothing because there's nothing else that can be done. She's gone. I want to ask you, what did you stop bothering the teacher about? Let me meet you where you at. What dream, goal, aspiration that you stopped praying about because it looked like it was dead? At what point did somebody have the kind of access that convinced you that there was nothing else that you could pray about because your thing was dead? I just purchased a first class ticket back to the pits of hell where that voice is sent to, because I rebuke it and I come against it and I bind it in the name of Jesus. You don't receive that. Get back to the teacher. That goal, that dream, that aspiration, whatever it was that you gave up on, go back and believe. And here's why. Here's why. I got receipts. Here's why. Because later on, Jesus literally told the Father, don't be afraid, just believe and she will be healed. Later on, Jesus goes up to the room, get to the girl. And he's like, bruh, she ain't dead. She's asleep. And they laughing like, boy, what? He literally looks at the girl, says, get up. Her spirit returned. And at once she stood up. Just because the process looks different, thank you, Holy Spirit, doesn't mean that the promise changed. Your promise is still there. God is still going to deliver. God is still going to heal where he needs to heal, provide where he needs to provide, change what he needs to change. God is still capable of doing that very thing. But because the process does not look like the promise, you are discouraged and you stop praying. God says, I am still here. But if I do things a little bit differently, if I don't make it there at the time that you want me there, but I can still show you that even on my time, I can still hand the very thing that you need in your hand. I can still do it. Your promise is still the same. Your dreams, what you want in life, can still be the same. The delivery just might be different. It's some things that God just needs to resurrect instead of healing. Ooh, that's good right there. I'm going to deliver it exactly how you need it. But you cannot get defeated. You cannot get discouraged because of how it looks. I can guarantee you it's coming. You just got to believe for it. Okay? You can keep scrolling.
God will find you. Sunland Apple IPTV Entertainment Perfected Faces done by Candy.
See, I didn't find God in the church. In fact, I didn't find God at all. He found me. He met me in a place where I was so broken, I couldn't get up. And when you're loved like that, it will shock you.
Whoever needs to hear this, listen now. God did not bring you this far to leave you. He did not bring you this far to... The scripture says that he that started a good work, he's faithful to see it through till the end. The work that the Lord has started in you is a good work. And he will surely see it through to the end. He says, he makes all things work together for good. For those that love the Lord and are called according to his purpose. His purpose. You did not find God. Contrary to the way it explained today that, oh, I found God. You did not find God. God was not lost. You was lost. God found you. And so if He finds you, He is big enough, strong enough, and able enough to secure you and to keep you. You've got to believe that. In the book of Matthew's chapter 6, verse 44, it says, "No one can come to you unless the Father who sent me draws him, and I will raise him up at the last day." Christ is saying that if the Father did not send you, if the Father did not send you to Him, you will not be able to know Him. So God found you. So you've got to believe that if He found you and He's brought you this far, then He's faithful enough, He's able enough, and He's more than willing to see you through to the very end, because He does a good work. He doesn't do unfinished business. No, the Lord finishes His work perfectly. The book of Ephesians 2 verses 10 says that we are God's masterpiece. We are God's masterpiece. Listen to these words. Created in Christ Jesus to do good works, which God prepared for us a long time ago. So before you were even born, there was a preparation for you. You've got to believe that, because it's true. Before you were formed in your mother's womb, I knew you. I'd set you apart. Right? So there's a preparation for you. There's a plan for you. There's a purpose for you. There's a path for you. And you are a masterpiece that is going through to perfection. You will be perfected. You're going through a process that is going to take you to perfection. The Lord did not bring you this far to leave.
God wants to be pursued. He's a relational God. He's a jealous God. He wants your heart. He wants your devotion. He wants your passion. In fact, He gives us an incredible promise in Jeremiah 29, verse 13. He says this, God says, "You will seek me." And what happens when you seek me? When you seek me, He says, you'll find me. It's a promise. If you pursue God, He will reveal Himself to you. You will seek me and find me. When you seek me with all your heart, God says, I will be found by you, declares the Lord. When you draw near to Him, when you pursue Him, when you crave Him, when you hunger for Him, God loves to be pursued, and He loves to reveal Himself to you.
To speak to people about a peg. So when you look at a peg, Sister Lerato, there's this silver spring in the center.
Yes.
A peg cannot function without the silver spring in the center. If I remove the silver spring in the center, it'll be just two pieces of planks that mean nothing. Same thing with your life. If I remove God at the center of your heart, you'll be a meaningless person. You wouldn't know your purpose. You wouldn't know your calling. You wouldn't know who you are. Number two, when you hang clothes on a line, why do you put a peg? You put a peg so that impacts zinga or zinga gold. Same thing with your life. Why do you receive God in your life? You receive God so that you don't fall into depression, anger, anxiety, bitterness, jealousy. That is why you need God in your life, so that you can be who you are and know your identity and purpose. Number three, if I remove the clothes from the pegs, impasses on zagalansis, this is all. So that is why it's very important to stick onto the Lord. Number four, Apex does not discriminate, Sisley Rad. It doesn't matter whether you are rich, whether you are poor, whether you are filthy, whether you are dirty. Apex's job is to hold him back. It does not matter who you are. Apex is going to hold you. Isn't this is the same thing that God says? Come as you are. It doesn't matter how broken. It doesn't matter what happened in your life. God is saying that just come as you are. Right now, during this lockdown, there's somebody that's broken. It's saying that I have no future. There's no hope, Bungan. But I want to tell you, God is saying, come as you are. And the word fear, Sisley Rato, the word fear, this word, fear, it has two meanings for me, Sisley Rato. It says, first meanings from the enemy. And people will say, forget everything and run away from the promises that God has for you. It's saying forget. But I want you to turn it around today. I don't care what situation you're facing today. Turn it around. Face everything and rise. I don't care what situation you've been through. A lot of people, they might have thrown stones. Like dogs do not bark at a car that stands still, but dogs bark at a car that's moving. So what I'm telling you, run, hustle. It's difficult. Today I'm an author, Cicely Rato. My friends, when I shut my
looked in the mirror lately, wish you could trade eyes with me. There's complexities in complexion, but your skin is glow like diamonds. Dig me like the earth, you be giving birth to everything alive, baby, know your worth. I love everything about you, from your nappy curls to every single curve, your body natural. Same skin that was broken, be the same skin taking over. Most things out of focus view, but when you're in the room, they notice you. You in all of your glory. Your skin is not only dark, it shines and it tells your story. Keep dancing, they can't control you. They watching, they